It just means a lot to me to play American songs to American people, even though sometimes I don't know what America is exactly. It feels like, you know, instead of being some sort of like animal that's been taken away in the circus and is in a cage being on display, it feels like I'm in my natural environment. Yeah, leading up to this album, I quit touring for about 2 years. I did that mainly because having started touring and putting out albums and doing interviews and stuff when I was 17 and doing that for like 4, 5, 6 years straight, there was a lot of like interference in my thought process trying to write a song. I decided that it was worth the risk for me to pack it all up for a while and go home and try to find a job. So that's what I did.
Walking home all burned and broken, with the front door my heart opens. Once inside words are spoken, asking how to mend a broken.
He has the ability to make people just stop and listen. It's very difficult in this day and age because there's a lot of distractions and things that are dragging you left and right. And Willy is one of those musicians that will make you stop. When he decides to sing his songs, when he decides to say what he wants to say, it's completely compelling, really earnest and genuine and honest. And you know, those kind of artists, you want to hold on to them, and you want them to make more records. So I'm just glad he's making records. I kind of assumed that he would just go off and do something else with his life. But I just thought maybe music, maybe he didn't like the industry, maybe he didn't like what he found. So every time I get a Willy Mason record, it's precious to me. Bad enough.
Chasing dreams that end in pain. I chase the sun, I chase the rain. Nothing ever seems to fill my cup. I see the angels circling now. I feel the moon behind the clouds.
Once like all the noise in my head had cleared out a little bit, and I wasn't distracted by writing for anything but the sake of the song, I built up an album's worth of material, and I felt like they could go in a lot of different directions, but what that direction was wasn't obvious to me. I sort of wanted some sort of a guide or somebody with some musical ideas.
I was at Mara Carlisle, a good friend of mine, and I'd worked with her a few years ago, and she obviously had known Willy for a long time, talked about Willy to me quite a lot. And I think she'd spoken to Willy and tried to say that he should come over here and record. And I think we'd been talking about that for a couple of years, in fact, but nothing had ever happened. And then she just brought him over. Yeah, we just seemed to get on well. And then he played me a song he played into Tomorrow on the guitar. Just played it on the acoustic and sang it, and he played it so quietly and sang it so loud. that combination, I was just straight away, this is amazing. So the chord change and the way he phrased it and the power, it was completely determined to work with him after that. it was really easy. But I was like, okay, job done.
Give in to your bed, it's time for dreaming, sleepy head. You know that the world can wait. Forget about the past, shut your eyes and hope this lasts. And let out all the demons from your face. Don't be ashamed to take the lanes that your thoughts choose to follow. Just watch and wait as the landscape unfolds into tomorrow. Change is in the streets, you can feel it like a heartbeat. We share it like a common name. Faith slips to the sea, forget responsibility. Only then will you know what these mean. And you try to find a road that still runs clean and narrow. But all signs argue for the interstate with the logic of an arrow. I wish that I could sing like the trickster in the breeze that dances out the worry from your face. But I can only give you back the things you give to me and put them in a song for your escape. Darkness sets, the sun that's left may cause you to feel alone. Just take that feeling as your shelter. That's the one place we all can share a home.
The new record feels very free. You know, it feels like he's kind of grown up and accepted that he does want to write songs, he does want to be a musician, he does want to tour, he does like all the, you know, the fun that comes with it as well as the work and working with Dan Carey and getting the sounds right. And it sort of feels like he's finally kind of reached a point in, as a writer and as a performer, and where he's comfortable with all of that, comfortable with what he has to say. He's one of the special ones, and I think when he's written, released 10, 20, 30 albums, his back catalogue will be considered up there with the greats.
When you talk me down, I go down, I go down.
I'm looking forward to touring, putting, you know, having this big chunk of time, being done with the UK for now and being able to tour America, put the album out over there. You know, it's always felt like sort of an afterthought in the past because I'd be so sick of touring by the time I'd be done with England that, you know, I just would feel like I didn't have anything left for the US. But this time, I'm one step closer to Ninja. So I'm still going strong after 6 months or a year's worth of touring. And it just means a lot to me to play American songs to American people.
How did I come this way, come this way, come this way? But it's just another page. My book will have its day. Why can't I see?